Hello and welcome to Fender Play Live. I'm Brian Whelan, and today we're counting down the top five power ballads that you can learn from Fender Play. We'll show you the songs, riffs, and solos in action. We're going to give you some insider tips on why they rock so hard and melt our hearts, and how you can start playing them today. Plus, we have a very special guest coming on later in the show to perform with us, so stick around. Helping us with today's topic is our special guest, Jon MacLennan. Say hi, Jon.
Hey, what's up, Fender friends?
Great to have you here. We are also joined, as always, by the one and the only Dr. Dylan Caliguiri. Say hi, Dylan.
Hey, everybody. I hope you brought your heartstrings, because we're going to pluck them today. This is a big one. Power ballads.
It looks like you're broadcasting from some kind of dungeon, some kind of gothic basement. Where do they put you today, Dylan?
This is for the theme today. These are windows to nowhere. And a very power ballad type of idea. Yes,
I like it. It's very appropriate. All right. So Jon is a guitarist who has played with artists like Blues Traveler, Julian Lennon, and Steven Tyler. He's taught millions of people on YouTube, and he's also one of our Fender Play instructors. So Jon, start us off. Tell us what you're playing today.
Yeah, so today I've got my go-to three-tone Sunburst Tele, and I love this guitar. You know, a Tele is one of the major food groups of guitar, and I've got a maple neck here, bird's eye maple, actually. Gotta love a maple neck. And then the double binding really has a classic feel to it. And I'm going into a bigger pedal board today, which usually I don't do, but I've got some cool effects and things we're gonna dive into, and then that is plugged into one of my favorite amps of all time. Use this amp a ton on YouTube as well, and that is a 1967 Fender Bassman. And so I've got a little bit of a distorted tone here. Here's what it sounds like.
That was great.
That was good.
What a great guitar, and you sound so great playing it. That's awesome. Glad you're here. Fender fans, you're in good hands today. Dylan, tell us a little bit about what you're playing there.
Well, this is a Tele-centric episode, apparently. I'm playing a black Tele Ultra. This is an Ultra Tele. You can always tell it's an Ultra. It's got that, like, the emblem there that's got a tuner covering it right now, but... This is a great guitar. I'll try to play something different than what Jon played. Let's see. Then you break into the operatic power ballad out of there. That's just a taste.
That Texas
very
taste.
Dramatic. Yeah. And you guys both have the binding on there too, so perhaps there's some kind of connection between the body
We're
binding
bound.
And the power ballad. Yeah, you're bound.
In the groove today.
We are bound.
I love it. And I'm playing one of these Fender Paramount acoustics, which I love. I'm just going direct in, so I don't have any kind of pedals or special sauce on this at all. So I'm just kind of... It's a great sounding acoustic, though. It's very bright. I really like the sound of it. All right, so let's begin. If you guys have questions throughout the episode, just drop them in the comments below and we'll try to get to them. And of course, everything you hear today, you can learn on Fender Play after the show. So I'm going to kick things off myself with one of the first power ballads. The song was actually written in 1960 by Bootlow Bryant, and it was a hit for Roy Orbison and an album track for the Everly Brothers before becoming a monstrous hit in the mid-70s by the Scottish band Nazareth. So on Fender Play, they teach this song in G, and since it's impossible for me to sing in that key, I'm going to play it capoed at the 5th fret. So I'm in C, but I'll still be playing in G. Scars, love wounds. without rain. Love hurts. Ooh, love hurts. I'm young, I know, but even so. Thank y'all for indulging me on that. I did two verses, but I wanted to kind of show how you can kind of build from this arpeggiated kind of way of playing into more of a strum, so you can kind of amp up the drama as the song moves along. So let's back it up before we dig in into Love Hurts and talk a little bit broadly about power ballads. So what do we mean when we say power ballads? There's a couple things. We're going to come back to these again and again as we go through the episode, but I'm going to throw it out to the group, and I can start out with something, one of the easy ones, just the tempo. Power ballads are going to be pretty slow, moving up to, you know, like a medium tempo that, you know, some of these ones we're talking about today are kind of a slower, moderate tempo. So, you know, John, why don't you jump in? What is one other kind of earmark of a power ballad?
Yeah, so the tempo is so important. And then another thing would be basically being able to build. You know, so many of these songs start out more mellow, and then the whole time through the end, you know, you got these big power chords or big drums. And so that is definitely something that makes it epic, you know?
Yeah, that's right. The scope of it. And you know, there's a comment coming in right now from Barbershop77. He says he's swaying with his lighter in his studio. Oh, so that speaks to exactly what you're saying, just the kind of epic Barbershop nature of these power ballads. Also, we have a question from Scott F. on YouTube. He wants to know, do ballads work better in certain keys? I want to throw this out to the doctor. Dr. Dylan, what do you think about that?
Indeed. Well, I think we all know that D minor is the saddest of all keys.
That's right. So, I was glad you got that.
If you are, if your power ballad errs on the side of a drama, then perhaps D minor is the best key. But guitaristically, of course, they work well when they're in keys where you either have open chords or you could use a capo to create open chords, which would be any key. But, go ahead.
Can chime in on that as well, you know, with just what Brian demonstrated. You know, everybody has a key that's going to work for them. So if you're a singer, you've got to find that key that fits your vocal range and sounds best, and everybody's going to be different. You know, even that recording of Love Hurts, you know, there's some original versions that are in G and he's just singing way high, and then the later ones, you know, it's in a lower key, and then, you know, maybe you want to do a capo, and so a capo is a great tool to use to be able to just take like the chords you already know and then just move the capo up and down the neck. Oh, I need it higher. And you don't really have to rethink all the chords. You're just going to play it higher up the neck. But it's definitely something everybody should try to optimize for. There isn't like a key as far as, oh, I sing in the key of G and every song works for that. It depends on the melody and basically the tune that you're playing. But you should research and try and experiment with moving the key, especially if you're a singer, you know, and you're going to play one of these songs.
Yeah, it's a great call, John. And you watched the same YouTube videos that I did prepping for this, where one gets the feeling that the singer for Nazareth probably sung this song one time in G
when they
were recording it. And then almost immediately after, they took it down to F or E.
Went to the
D
hospital.
And these musicians, too, they're on tour. You know, they're singing night after night. And so, you know, you have to be able to do something that's sustainable. And sometimes in the studio, you're going to hit those one notes. It's going to sound great. You're going to make the record. But then, you know, going live, you may have to change the key. So
absolutely. All right. So let's move on to another power ballad. John, why don't you hit us with another one? What are we going to hear next?
Yeah. So another great one on the site is Tesla Love Song. And if you're going to be a guitar player in a band and you're going to work with other musicians, or even if you just want to play your own version of a song at home, what you want to be able to do is some different techniques. And Brian did such a cool job where he started off playing with more of like arpeggio picking, you know, and then he moved to strumming, and that helps the song develop, you know. And so back on this theme of developing, I'll play a little bit of this Tesla Love Song. Now, the intro is pretty epic. It starts off with these acoustic guitars, and then it builds into electrics and power chords. But I'll just play a bit of the intro for you, and you can check it out. It's more of like what's called a fingerstyle way of playing, or finger picking. Here's what it sounds like. And so the tune starts out like that way, and then of course it comes in, there's a 12-string guitar that comes in, they go through that theme again. And so, you know, if you're gonna play these songs in a band, you might have to be able to play a little bit with a pick and kind of pick some notes. And then you might have to play distorted power chords at the end, right? Where you maybe turn on a distortion pedal and you play, you know, big power chords, or you start the song off, you know. Sometimes you would see these bands play live and they'd have like a guitar on a stand, you know, you've seen those, and they've got one guitar slung behind their back like this. And so they come out front and maybe they play that first finger picking part on a nylon string, and then the drums come in and they pull the guitar around and kick into it. And so, you know, being able to develop those techniques, which you can learn, you know, on Fender Play from being able to arpeggio pick and strum some chords, is really going to help you to be able to play these songs or play in a band.
Yeah, that's a great point. And, you know, there's something I noticed when you were playing that I think is another kind of a pattern that we see for power ballads, where you're kind of almost invoking this Baroque sense a little bit. This very kind of harpsichord, kind of Bach sounding figure, but you're obviously playing it on guitar, but like you mentioned, a nylon string. I mean, that would be a callback to a classical era, right?
100%. I mean, you got this, like even just the way the pull-offs are there. It sounds very like what you're saying. I just think classical.
Yeah, it's kind of on the funny side, Spinal Tap that got referenced earlier, but it's also very real. It's something that you kind of see it across all these songs that we're talking about.
That was
today.
D major, so if it was the saddest key, it would have to be
close. Very smooth. I like it. Okay. All right. We have a question coming in, and we get this question a lot, but and we're happy to talk about this because it's important. A question from Michael on YouTube: are power ballads typically done on electric or acoustic? Dylan, what say you?
Gosh, I think John had the right take there. A lot of times they involve both.
Yeah.
Both electric and acoustic, and they're crucial elements. I think there's an escapism element, right? When you're evoking those Baroque tendencies and the trills and whatnot, that sounds like strings. And then when you move to electric, there's a bit of a operatic, you know, over the top element that happens. And so I think both is the answer.
It's a good answer. Well, and I think that you can really do it on either also is another way of looking at it. I mean, I played Love Hurts earlier, the Nazareth recording of Love Hurts. is an electric guitar that's right. that's plugged into an amp and maxed out, and it has a phaser on it, and it's very sounds psychedelic, great. And it sounds yeah. great. And he's playing this arpeggiated pattern, but it's not a huge jump to play that on an acoustic, and it gives it a different vibe. It turns it into more of a kind of a campfire feel a little bit, but it's the same song, it's the same chords, and so, you know, like Dylan says, both or either are correct. And we get that question every time, and it's yeah. really important to talk about because, you know, of course they're different instruments, but a guitar is a guitar, and you should be able to play these songs on both or either or, you know, whatever you have lying around. Question from Abby, is there an era or genre that power ballads tend to fall into? This is a good question. John, you want to jump on this one?
Yeah, I mean, I think of a power ballad personally as just more of like the stylistic thing. So you could have had a power ballad in the 60s and you can have a power ballad, you know, released yesterday or whatever. So it's more about these techniques and elements, tempo, you know, dynamics. And then I think lyrical content as well, you know, plays a role as well.
Absolutely. Yeah. And again, Love Hurts was a hit, you know, three or four different times over a, I don't know, 15 or 20 year period or something like that, just done in different styles. And so like you say, the spirit of the power ballad is more in some of these things that we're talking about today, like the tempo, the drama, certainly this kind of use of these first position kind of open chords and relatively simple chord progressions. These are the things that kind of bind them together. So for all the viewers out there, please, you know, make sure to tell us your favorite power ballads in the comments, because we want to know what gets your lighter waving out there, and we'll yes. shout them out as they come. In the meantime, I've got another ballad I'm going to sing for you. This is going to be Sister Christian. Sister Christian, your time has come, and you know that you're cycles out in the parking lot getting ready to just take off on 101 there. Oh my gosh. Okay.
So good.
So favorite power ballads from viewers. We got them coming in now. Randy X wants to shout out I Remember You. William Purchase says More Than Words. That one's on Fender Play. You can go learn that one right now.
Great song.
Kurt says Alone Again by Dokken.
Oh man.
We got one here. Oh, Kubrick Lover, 1972, November Rain. How could we have forgot that one?
That's,
Which is, I mean, that's epic, an epic video too, which you got to have for a power ballad. You need an epic video. Ted wants to shout out Holiday by the Scorpions. These are all great. So keep them coming, and we're going to keep shouting them out here. Oh, here we go. This is a good question. What are John and Dylan's favorites? Dylan, I know what yours is. Why don't you go first?
Actually, November Rain. Is my all-time favorite.
That is a good one. You know, I thought you were gonna say the Whitesnake song.
Here I Go Again.
Yeah, well, Here I Go Again.
You know, it's way up there. It's way up there. But I think November Rain is definitely my all-time favorite. You know, all these songs have that like monomyth deal where it starts out with a story about love and it turns into something grandiose where there's a lot of stuff that happens and then you arrive back home again. But if you're new to guitar and you're hearing this stuff for the first time, don't be dismayed by some of the difficulty that you're hearing, because there's everything that we've talked about so far. Like, for instance, John was talking about a capo. We're talking about fingerstyle guitar. All this stuff is on Fender Play. So if there's a particular technique that you like, you can just use the search bar. But if there's a particular style or genre, you can of course use that. But all these things can be, you know, melted down piecemeal, and you can take them on. So don't be discouraged. You can be a ballad balladeer yourself.
Yeah. Very good, very good. Also, and Gary Flynn is shouting out Stairway to Heaven, which of course is a great call. Just, I mean, don't play it in the guitar store. They might throw you out.
You can get a lot of trouble for that.
The Forbidden.
Right. Yeah, the Forbidden. and maybe you're noticing, if you're watching this at home, a lot of these songs revolve around the same chord changes, where there's a lot of 1-4-5-6, pretty much everything we've played so far has that. So that's one kind of pattern where if you can learn all these first position chords, there's like almost no end to what you can play, including all these power ballads. Yep. Okay, so we have got a very special guest to bring in now. He's going to sing us one of the all-time great power ballads by the late, great Meatloaf. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Heather Youmans. Welcome, Heather. Thanks for being here.
Heather!
Hey, hi, Dylan.
Surprise visit.
Thanks for having me on.
Thanks for coming on. This is going to be great. Now, you and Jon are married,
yeah.
So this is perfect for a Valentine's Day episode.
Oh.
So why don't you take it away whenever you're ready?
Let's do it.
And I would do anything for love. I'd run right into hell and back. I would do anything for love. I'll never lie to you, and that's a fact. But I'll never forget the way you feel right now. Oh no, no. But I won't do that. No, I won't do that. And some days it don't come easy, and some days it don't come hard. Some days it don't come at all, and these are the days that never. And some nights you're breathing fire, and some nights you're carved in ice. Some nights you're like nothing I've ever seen before. Oh, real again. And maybe I'm crazy. Oh, it's crazy and it's true. I know you can save me. No one else can save me now but you. As long as the planets are turning, as long as the stars are burning, as long as your dreams are coming true, you better believe it. And I would do anything for love. Oh, I would do anything for love. I would do anything for love. But I won't do that. I would do anything. Just won't do. I would do anything for love, anything you've been dreaming of, but I just won't do. And some days I pray for silence, and some days I pray for soul. Sometimes I just pray to the gods of sex and drums and rock and roll. And maybe I'm lonely, that's all I'm qualified to be. There's just one and only promise I can keep. As long as the wheels are turning, as long as the fires are burning, as long as your prayers are coming true, you better believe it, that I would do anything for love. And you know it's true, and that's a fact. And I would do anything for love. And there'll never be no turning back. Will you make it all a little less cold? Yeah, I can do that. Will you cater to every fantasy I got? Will you hose me down with holy water if I get too hot? Will you take me all the places I've never known? I know the territory I've been around. It'll all turn to dust and we'll all fall down. And sooner or later you'll be screwing around. No, I won't do anything for love, but I won't do that.
Beautiful. Yes. Yes.
Thank you.
Heather, that was yes. great. What a voice.
Thanks. We learned amazing. It just for everybody on the line right now. It is a beast of a song with so many
it
sections.
Sure is.
Yeah, there's a lot going on there. Yeah. Well, thanks so much for joining us. That is such a special treat for all of us. And I mean, that was just, I mean, I don't know. I think we have to follow that with another song, but you know, that's okay. We can get it done. That was great. Thank you so much for joining us. That was
Thank
awesome.
You.
Heather. That was fantastic.
Thank you so much.
Not easy to reduce that song down. You guys did a really great job. What a power couple. Power couple doing a power ballad.
The best guitar players are the best listeners. That's what singers love. So don't forget it.
Absolutely. Heather, just before you go, where can we hear your music? After the show, where should our listeners go to hear your music?
You can head on over to heatheryoumans.com. That's Heather, Youmans. .com. Thank you so much. Thanks for having me on.
Thanks for
great
being
job.
Here. That was great.
Yeah.
All right. So John is going to actually break down this song a little bit and tell us something about some of the kind of patterns that kind of go across all these power ballads and kind of bring them all together. So John, what are you going to break down for us about that song in particular and power ballads in general?
Yeah, so that song, you know, it's on the site, you know, Fender Play. And the thing about that song is it's a roller coaster. You know, you've got all these different sections and dynamics, and it's just so fun to go through. And what I wanted to share was just like a couple things. Like, let's say you were to perform this song, you know, with an acoustic guitar or whatever guitar you got, electric, and you wanted to maybe do a video or you wanted to play it for your friends and family. And so how can you take, you know, we're talking about all the different elements, the different guitars and things, but how do you just kind of bring it all down to just playing with one guitar? And so some things, I'll give you just a couple points that you can kind of hone in on. And so that chorus, you know, anything for love, the first thing you want to do is start by just really holding down, just think about a simple strumming pattern. And on Fender Play, so many times with the lessons, we'll say, you're learning a chord progression, we'll say, okay, let's just go through it with whole notes. You know, and you're just working on kind of marking out those changes. What I would really emphasize is just being able to do that with the song. So like, anything for love, you know, and just really holding it down. Then from there, you can bring in like, so what I did there was add like what Brian played on Love Hurts, which again, these techniques, you know, once you start getting it down, it'll apply to these power ballads, but not even just power ballads, it's just guitar in general. So that's a big win. But what I did there was I strummed the chord and then you just break up the chord. So instead of strumming it all at once, you pick individual strings and that's like the arpeggio picking. Now, when you're playing with a singer or you're accompanying yourself, you want to do that in the gaps, you know? So like, if you think about the melody, anything for love, you know, you don't want to be doing all the busy stuff behind the vocal, because then it's like they're getting in the way of each other. So filling the gap, but it would be boring if I just did the simple strums, like if I just went, anything for love. You know, there's like this space in there, so, right? And then, so I'm always listening, you know, when I'm accompanying to, you know, being able to kind of just complement the vocal. And so if you're doing this on guitar at home, you want to think about those different techniques and ways that you can create a part that sounds really cool just by yourself. Now, the last thing I'll say is, tones. So one thing I did was on the pre-chorus, I did this, like, and you hear the sound like. So I turned on an effect, and this is, that in particular is like a Leslie, kind of sounds like an organ part, you know, and that can break up your song, you know. So, and this applies to just playing on your own, but it also applies to playing with a band, where you may have a technique that you use for one part of the song, but then you also have a tone, you know, so you play that, and then you're back to just simple strumming. And then maybe later with a band, you know, it's like, it's a distorted guitar tone. And you know, like the Fender Mustang amps are so great because they have so many of those effects just in one. You've got like these crazy pedal boards all built into the amp. So being able to think about how you can use those different techniques to play an epic power ballad, you know, but just do it yourself, you know.
Those are great points. And like Heather said, you know, the best guitar players and really the best musicians are always listening. You know, you listen to what, you know, what the other musicians are playing. And really, most importantly, listen to what the singer's doing. And then you can kind of, you can simplify it when someone is singing. And then when they stop singing is when you can put in your tasty licks or your, you know, arpeggiated things or bring in an effect or something like that. Also, one thing I love that you said is like when you're arranging for a single guitar, backing up a vocalist, you're the whole band.
Right.
So you're breaking, you know, you're reducing a song that has traditional rock rhythm section, bass, drums, and guitars, keyboards, you know, pianos, organ, you know, which you reference with your rotary pedal. And then even like something like this is going to have strings. It's going to have, you know, orchestral touches as well. And so you're doing it all on a Telecaster, and, you know, you did a great job and a great reduction of that as well. Lovely.
Thanks so much.
We promised 5 songs for you. So we got one more, and it's going to be tough to top Heather and Jon doing Meatloaf, but I'm going to do my best. I'm going to close the show out with one of the classic power ballads. This is Every Rose Has Its Thorn. Check this out, guys.
Silently still in the dead of the night. Although we both lie close together, we feel miles apart inside. Was it something I said or something I did? Did the words not come out right? Although I tried not to hurt you, and though I tried, I guess every rose has its thorn. It's dawn, just like every cowboy sings a sad, sad song. Every rose has its thorn.
And it's true, guys. No one's perfect. Not me. Not even Dr. Dylan. So that's Every Rose Has Its Thorn. You can learn that on Fender Play. Like I said, it's a classic. Classic power ballad, and glad to wrap it up with that one today. These have all been great songs. Thank you guys for being here and breaking these down with us. Dylan, thanks for playing air drums whenever you. Yeah, that's right.
Man, that was, you had it. You channeled.
We had it. I could see some lighters going out there, and so
absolutely,
100%
out in the park. Yeah. Okay. All right. Let's get to the homework, Dylan. Please help us out with the homework today.
Yeah, man. What, you guys did such a great job on this, and Heather, what a treat. What a treat
she
that
was. Great.
Was. So if you're a beginner, you may have noticed a common shape between all the songs that were played. That's the power chord shape. And there's tons of lessons on Play about power chords. They're just a really simple shape that kind of is really accessible when you're new to guitar. And I'll let you guys check those out online. But the main thing is to play a power chord. Learn your first power chord if you're brand new. If you're intermediate, learn the chords to Every Rose Has Its Thorn, right? So It's going to be a challenge, but you'll be able to do it. And then finally, if you're advanced, learn all of I Would Do Anything for Love. And that includes the face painting and everything that's required. You have to live in a tower for a year, all the stuff. So that's going to be a major undergoing. I hope you have a pen and paper, but it's on the site. Check all three of those out. You can do it. You can do it.
Wonderful. And I want to find out this week's winner. So Dylan, I want you to keep rolling with that. Let's talk about
the
gear giveaway this week.
Absolutely. So we get to give away a piece of gear to a lucky Fender Play subscriber simply for using Fender Play for 21 minutes or 3 7-minute sessions called Streaks. You're automatically entered to win if you belong on Fender Play. And all you got to do is just show up and play your guitar for a little bit, right? Guitar, bass, ukulele, whatever it is that you play. So you get to pick from guitars, amps, basses, all kinds of different gear. Do you guys want to hear who won this week?
I definitely do. Please tell me.
Can you give me a power ballad, build up? Here we go. Brian W, but not this Brian W, not this.
Wait,
one.
I won?
No.
Oh, I'm getting the voice.
I'm sorry.
In the ear here.
You know what? It's Brian H. Brian H. That's why. Oh, our producer says sorry, blame it on me. I was going to do that anyways, so it kind of just it works out. But final answer. Brian H.
Congratulations,
sir. It's a little disappointing for me,
so
but it's great
for
Brian
you.
H.
Sorry about that, Brian.
No,
tough luck.
It's okay. I got lots of guitars. Congrats to you, Brian, and please enjoy your new guitar, bass, amp, whatever you choose. What else do you have for us, Dylan? Are there any Fender Play updates we should know about?
Yeah, there's new songs on the site. There's new stuff on the site. There's new paths on the site. There's new all kinds of things on the site. There's constantly stuff that's coming on the site. Feedback mode is awesome. I don't know if you guys have checked that out, but one new song that's on there that's there's some power ballads of my generation, but they're not your typical power ballads. They're brooding. See if you guys recognize this. Does anybody recognize that? Woo! Yeah. See, now our power ballads, none of the words are decipherable whatsoever. So they didn't have the same. Right. Of course, that's Even Flow by Pearl Jam. Pink Panther theme. There's tons of new stuff on there. You got to check it out. Dig around. I think you'll have a good time.
Great. Check all that out when you can. Huge thanks to John for powering through the top 5 power ballads.
Great job.
Fender Play Live with us. Thanks so much. And to Heather, too. You all were both great. We want to know what you have coming up. Anything you want to plug for us?
Yeah, so lots of stuff. You know, I'm here on YouTube as well, you know, just youtube.com/JohnMacLennan. And then my website, you know, just www.johnmacLennan.com. So J-O-N and then MacLennan.com. Got a lot of great resources on there as well. And then, of course, I'll be in the Fender Play videos, so I'll be seeing you in those videos.
Great. Well, we'll see you there. Thanks again for being here. You were great. All right, everybody. Keep safe. Keep practicing. And we'll see you next week at the same time, same place. Everybody, let's go out on a G chord.